talk about your success. So after your first record album, you bought your first home, which was $1 million at the time.
Ooh, yeah.
And then we shot Coming to America at your amazing house.
The Promised Land.
So I wanna know, how important was it for you to buy real estate when so many people are buying things that just show? Do you know what I mean? You bought real estate, which I think is really smart.
Most definitely, and that's what I promote the most to up-and-coming entrepreneurs, bosses, hustlers. I've never lost a coin on real estate.
Yeah. Mm.
That's something my mom taught me early on. Mm-hmm. They could make another car. They could make another this. They can't make that coin over. They gotta buy that coin.
Nice.
Yeah. And you've been hustling since you was 13 years old. You started off washing, you know, washing cars.
Right.
How did your early days of hustling shape you?
It just let me, I found out, you know, life is a competitive sport. You got to find a way to enjoy it, but it is a competitive sport.
Amen.
And I used to be behind the car wash waiting for the hustlers to pull up with their music turned up loud, boom, ba-boom, boom. And, you know, I let them know, you know, I put gas in your car, I organize your cassette deck, anything you need for that extra $5. Rosé wanted that too.
Was it's always money to be made, even when you make it money, it's extra money to be made.
Oh, most definitely. That was just something I knew at a young age. You gotta take advantage of your time. Multiply your output.
Yeah.
That's what being a boss is all about. Multiplying your
output. You are dropping gems right now. I love the life is a competitive sport.
Yeah. Yep.
It is. I
can only imagine, if we're getting these kinds of gems from you, I can only imagine the kind of gems that you drop on your kids.
Mm.
Your son, you just recently got him a Wingstop for his 16th birthday.
I did.
Why was that important to you?
Well, really, it was important to me the most, of course, is making sure he understand entrepreneurship and working for yours is the foundation of being a man.
But talk about how that helps our culture, Rick, because I think a lot of people need to understand.
Yeah, instead of buying a car or fancy jewelry, why the Wingstop and getting him a franchise?
Well, it helps. To me, it also, what meant the most to me is him walking in and out of them Wingstops since he was 4 and 5 years old, watching me chase my dreams. That was my way of rewarding him.
Yeah.
Stay down with me, because I would go in the Wingstop and pick up a broom. I'm sweeping. I look at him. He go get the dustpan.
So good.
You know what I mean?
Good.
And so I was just showing him that. And that's what's important. Ain't nothing wrong with having your own personal desires.
Right.
I remember being young and, you know, just watching the big boys and, oh, man, who would have imagined Rosé have on a $3 million watch? But, you know, these are realistic if you're going to go earn it.
Right. But he's like, I got a $3 million watch and I still grab the broom.
No one are going to give you nothing. They don't care about how bad your back ache and your ingrown toenails. No one wants to hear that.
Nope.
Everybody that's sitting at the table wants to win.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. Wow, I love everything you're saying. Let's talk about your music. You have your 11th album coming out.
Richer than I ever been.
Tell us about the process. Like, how do you come out with new music? What inspires you?
Well, you know, I believe what inspires me the most is the art itself, the culture itself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because for me, at album number 11, I'm still inspired by waking up, I'm sitting with, you know, beautiful queens like yourselves doing these interviews or sitting down with a journalist. You know, that's still a part of the process that I love. I still love going in the clubs, listening to the younger artists, listening to my classic records, Jeezy classic records.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's still a part of the process that I love the most. Mm-hmm. And that's just as relevant to me as making the music.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, you know, and every day we wake up, you're richer than you ever been.
Ooh.
You're further than you've ever been.
Let them know.
Yeah, without a doubt. You're close to accomplishing whatever it is.
But on this album, you're collaborating with Future, Jasmine Sullivan. Who else would you like to collaborate? I mean, because you're bringing out big names.
Mm-hmm. And I always have, but I think what would mean the most to the boss is Rick Ross and Sade.
Ooh!
I would there front and center.
That would be amazing.
That would be good.
Who would be your favorite verses?
My favorite verses?
Mm-hmm.
Jay-Z and who?
Ooh, that's a hard one.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, to me, that's what makes verses special. because it brings out the best in both parties. We saw just what happened.
So you and Jay-Z.
Oh, that's a possibility, but I gotta give my flowers to the big homie.
Right.
My homie gave me my first opportunity signing me to Def Jam Records, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And he's one of one. Rest in peace to B.I.G.
Amen.
You know, Tupac. That would have been the verses of verses.
Oh.
Tupac and B.I.G.
Yes, hands down.
Without a doubt.